welcome to Lohre Farm. We just got back from a cabin trip at my parents' house, and it did rain a little bit while we were gone, so the garden just kind of exploded, which is super exciting because when we left we just had a few little zucchinis, and now as you can see I have a bunch ready to pick, so I'm gonna go ahead and pick some. We have Black Beauty variety and another variety which I can't remember, but they're all really delicious. So this is my Black Beauty one, and I usually just twist them and they just pop right off like that. You can also use a knife and slice them off too. Oh my, this is ginormous. Look at the size of that. Gonna make a few loaves of zucchini bread. I have so many they don't fit in my basket. It's a good problem to have. I'm ready on that one. All right, and then over here we got our cucumbers. I'm just gonna take a peek at them and see where we're at with them. They're flowering nicely and really growing out and vining out very, very well. You can see all the tendrils here and they're just vining out beautifully. I'm not seeing any cucumbers yet, but the flowers are looking amazing. Cucumber plants here to see if we have any cucumbers growing yet. And so far I'm not seeing any. I'm just seeing a bunch of these really pretty flowers, but not quite any little baby cucumbers, unfortunately, but hopefully soon. I'll just check over here. Yep, I'm not seeing any quite yet. Well, maybe in a week or two. Hopefully by our next garden tour, you'll be able to see a few cucumbers, or hopefully I'll be able to pick some. So the corn's even grown. It's gotten my height, so at least 5'2", even a little bit taller than 5'2", so that really sprouted up nicely, and it looks like we have a few ears of corn right here growing in, so that's really exciting. Getting excited to have corn for dinner since it's been a while. We did freeze some last year, and we ate it throughout the winter, but you have to be careful how you cook it, because if you don't boil it real fast, if it's frozen, then it goes to mush. We learned that one the hard way. So we're in the back garden here where I have my beans and my beets and my tomatoes and my more tomatoes and potatoes, and the beans are looking good. We're actually starting to get some here, and not quite big enough to pick, but they should be picked here shortly. I got a whole bunch. They kind of blend right in here, but here's some pretty good sizable ones, and they're kind of all over. So I'm thinking we'll probably have beans later this week, maybe Thursday or Friday. And they're looking fabulous. They're just growing everywhere. They blend in so well that they're kind of hard to find until they get really sizable. I like to pick them when they're about the size of my hand length. The potatoes are starting to fall over because we were gone this weekend, so I didn't get a chance to keep up on my healing, but I am gonna kind of dig through here and see how they're looking. We have a few little ones growing in right here, so that's kind of exciting. Tomatoes have gotten out of control, as you can see also, but out of control in a good way. We have a whole bunch of them. They're literally everywhere. They're kind of camouflaged in there, but they are all over the place and they smell delicious. I love the smell of a tomato plant. Just looking great. Oh yeah, here's a pretty sizable one right here. Hopefully that turns red in here soon. We got another sizable one right back here. These beets have caught up to almost the front patch we have right over there. Looking really great. Yeah, we got some sizable ones in here. We'll be able to have some nice salads this week and also some more beets with our green beans. Our snap peas are looking great. I'm not seeing any flowers yet. Oh, yep, a couple flowers. So we'll have some snap peas here shortly. Look at all them. I'm surprised I don't have any snap peas growing yet. Unless my kids got back here before I got to shoot the video and ate them all, which is a possibility. And the carrot box is looking super good. Needs to be weeded again from being gone for the long weekend. But they are coming in fabulously. Just get rid of a few little weeds here. None shouldering quite yet, so hopefully they'll start, you know, popping through and shouldering, and we'll get a few really long ones to eat. We have a ton of wild raspberry bushes growing. They were here before we moved in, and as you can see, they're just all over the place. So me and the kids will probably come out later and shoot a video of us picking all of them and have us this nice snack. They're literally surrounding our entire property and all the way back into the woods, and they've grown wild since we have moved in here, and there is just a ton of them. You can see all of these. They aren't quite red yet, but we do have a ton red. The nice thing is they kind of go in a cycle, so you'll get a bunch of red ones and then you won't and then you will. You kind of never run out of them when you have thousands of them. And they're all over the whole property here. There's even some more right there you can see. Might even pick one and eat it. Pretty good. We're in greenhouse number one, just checking in on my beets and green beans. And again, they need to be weeded, but they're looking really good. Looks like they're just about caught up to the outside planter boxes. Let's see if we can see any green beans growing in here yet. I definitely see some flowers, but I don't know if I'm seeing any green beans quite yet. Looking good though. Yep, so no green beans quite yet, but they're growing, we're flowering. I suspect in the next couple of days we'll be having a ton of beans for dinner. Probably have to pickle some. We're in greenhouse number two here, which I am really excited about because while we were gone, my yellow zucchini or my yellow squash just exploded. It looks like an Amazon jungle in here. I mean, look at the leaves on these things. They're huge. They've really sprouted in here. They've done amazing. We've got flowers poking through here too. Not quite growing any that I found yet, but so many flowers. So we just need to get them pollinated and in here, and then hopefully by my next garden video, we'll have some yellow ones growing because these are looking really fabulous. The tomato plants are hanging in there too. They're growing and getting bigger. And I can't wait to see how big they get hanging upside down. I suspect they're gonna get to the point where they're touching my yellow squash, but we'll see how that goes. And then my peppers, while we were gone, have just gone bananas, which is awesome. I mean, look at the size of these. They're so big. And we have so many. They're looking great. Look at the size of this one. Yeah, we're definitely gonna be having peppers here for sure. There's a ton more flowers than there was when I left even, and they're getting bigger. These guys are looking good. My jalapenos over there are looking amazing. My sweet peppers, so nice. There's even some hidden in here. You can't even tell until you look right in there and then they pop out at you. This is another one of my sweet peppers. This is gonna be perfect size for the kids to munch on. The jalapenos, they're coming through nicely too. Got a couple on that one, actually got three or four already. We're back here in Chaos Garden, which is looking a lot better than I honestly thought it was going to. The weeds still haven't quite caught up. We do have some weeds poking through, but not a whole lot, and it has quite the variety. I mean, I can already see pumpkin. We have beans and corn popping through. It's looking really amazing. It's really taken off. It's looking fabulous. I'm excited to see what the next couple of months bring and what we actually grow from here that we can eat. It's definitely been a fun experiment, and honestly, I think we will probably do this 2 years to come, the way this is turning out. It's kind of fun not knowing what's in here and seeing what actually grows without us having to do much work. So I know this doesn't have anything to do with gardening, but we did get two new family members today. We got Pretzel here, and we also have little Miss Daisy. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button if you have not, and we'll see you back here next week for a new update. Thank you.